And with that, it's time for me to invite yet another renowned personality we have in our midst. Ladies and gentlemen, the person I'm going to call on stage, I mean, what do I talk about him? The dreamer, the thinker, the visionary he is. Ladies and gentlemen, I would now like to call upon Chief Guest, SEBI Chairman, Shri Ajay Tyagi, to share the keynote address with all of us. And may I request everyone to kindly put your hands together and welcome our Chief Guest with a huge round of applause. Over to you, sir.
Shri Deepak Parekh, Shri Bala Subramanian, Shri Venkatesh, friends from media, officers from SEBI, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I thank AMFI for inviting me for this function. So this is the second year I am attending this function. Last year also it was the same venue. And every time I see even larger gathering for this, it gives me great pleasure to address this August gathering today. But I'm equally aware that you're all experts on the subject and would have seen the industry from much closer quarters. The bigger challenge for me, therefore, is to engage the attention. But I must admit that Mr. Parekh, in his candid address, if I may say, has already made my task easier by raising many issues which are extremely relevant. And, you know, it is something which all of you should go back and consider very carefully and seriously. Now, mutual funds have become an important constituent of Indian financial system by channelizing investor savings to the capital market. By the very nature of their market operations that involve continuous buying, selling, and holding various listed scripts or debt instruments, mutual funds significantly impact savings, investments, and liquidity, and in turn, the overall status of financial markets. Against this backdrop, I would like to discuss certain issues that are essential for maintaining, that I feel are essential for maintaining investor confidence in the industry, and also share some thoughts that I believe could be helpful in further improving the regulatory framework for mutual funds in India. And the issues touched upon by me in my address are illustrative and by no means exhaustive. Much has been said about the growth of the mutual fund industry starting in 1963 with UTI and where it is today, so I need not actually repeat that. But this change in AUM, which has been said over the last 2 years increase, if you say last 4 years, it is more than doubled. And what is more encouraging, of course, is that number of folios, which in last 1 year itself also, if I compare, they increased from 7.59 crore in July 2018. They increased from 5.99 to 7.59 over 1 year, increase of 27% in 1 year, which is really very encouraging. And all this campaign of mutual funds Sahi Hai towards equity participation by retail investors is something which is making it a mass movement, which is really very, very encouraging. And despite this growth, as also said by previous speakers, AUM accounts for only 11% of GDP. So, and as compared to US, where it's more than 100% or world average, if I heard Mr. Parekh rightly, about 62% or something. So naturally, fund industry in India has a lot to catching up to do, and there are a lot of opportunities for the growth, as has already been presented in presentations by AMFI. So I'll straight away go to the issues and challenges which I feel are relevant to the industry. First is, let me start with the concentration issue. It is a cause of concern that despite such tremendous growth, majority of market share of industry remains concentrated in a few big players. The top four mutual funds account for almost 50% of industry AUM, and top seven mutual funds account for around 70% of industry AUM. Concentration in the industry is evident not only in the AUM figures, but also in the revenue and profit margins of mutual funds. It is observed that share of revenue of seven large AMCs is more than 60% of the total industry revenue. Profit margin, that is PBT as a percentage of revenue, of large mutual funds has also stood at a very healthy rate, somewhere between 40 to 50%. It is therefore apparent that large AMCs have a fairly high market share of total AUM, revenues and profits for the industry as a whole, indicating a high concentration of the industry in few hands. Is this concentration due to lack of adequate competition in the fund space? Are such disproportionately high profits due to high TERs, especially in equity funds? You would appreciate that from overall industry perspective, an industry which is growing and which is likely to grow much more, as has been rightly said by the previous speakers, some thinking perhaps is required to bring in elements that facilitate a healthy competition in the industry, which we feel is lacking as of now. Second, the issue of risk management and valuation. As the industry gears up to move to the next level of growth in terms of size, aspects of risk management and valuation become even more important. And let me dwell a bit, little bit more on this issue. Valuation is extremely important for mutual funds. This is one area that is fundamental, that is of fundamental importance, as it has direct ramifications on the integrity of the industry as a whole. This is especially true for debt mutual funds. It is observed that exposure of mutual funds is more than 91% in AA minus and above rated long-term debt instruments, and almost 100% in A1 plus rated short-term debt instruments. Further, retail participation in debt-oriented funds is less than 7% of AUM, and that in liquid funds is even lesser at around 2% of AUM. In other words, around 11,50,000 crore of debt AUM out of total of 12,30,000 crore is held by non-retail investors. Debt mutual funds are also being used by non-retail investors mostly to park their short-term funds. Debt funds therefore have to be even more vigilant about the risk, kind of risk they are taking, and how these risks are being valued so as to ensure that the portfolio is adequately reflecting the maturity, transposition, and liquidity risk properly. The industry further needs to think of new and innovative ways for deepening the bond market. In this context, use of bouquet of products like debt ETFs and bond index tracking funds could perhaps be considered for development. Another issue is of good governance. Mutual funds are entrusted with the task of being the caretaker of investors' funds, and they perform an important public utility function. Retail investors have around 51% share in terms of participation in equity-oriented schemes. It follows that despite being profit-making entities, fund houses have strong public interest responsibilities incumbent upon them. It is therefore important for them to maintain the highest order of good governance and integrity. Some recent cases, the details of which I need not get into, do not augur well with the public service character of the industry and have to be avoided at all costs. An arm's length relationship with respect to related party investments, as also avoiding conflict of interest, is the need of the hour. It stands to reason that the lens for observing the conduct and accountability of AMCs, their board of trustees and their professional managers will have to be that of the highest standard. Now, I'll share some thoughts for further improvement. As I said, they're only illustrative and by no means exhaustive. They cannot be in such a wide industry and such a short period of presentation here. One is, which is very close to SEBI's heart, is, as I said, that retail participation, and in that context, geographical expansion of markets, the need for expanding it further. And this has been one of the major focus areas of SEBI. Admittedly, growth in AUM from B15 cities has been quite satisfactory in recent years, and the same has grown in tandem with growth of AUM of overall mutual fund industry. The B15 AUM as a percentage of industry AUM has climbed from 12.7% in 2012-13 to 17.7% in 2017-18. I feel the time is now ripe for industry to concentrate on B30 centers, and as I said earlier, perhaps even beyond some time for B50 centers. There is thus a need for accelerated and faster growth in geographical reach of mutual funds and bring in long-term money from smaller towns. This is also necessary given that there is an overall policy focus to channelize more of household savings towards financial assets. Towards this end, I hope that the dispensation to allow AMCs to charge additional TER of 30 basis points of new inflows from beyond top 30 cities would facilitate in further deepening the industry. Next issue is of ease of doing business. Towards the larger goal of ease of doing business, SEBI has introduced various measures in the recent past, like allowing instant access facility, payment through e-wallets for investment mutual funds. Besides many other recent initiatives like standardization and rationalization of open-ended schemes and introduction of total return index as the benchmark index for mutual fund schemes have also been undertaken with the objective of helping the investors in terms of better comparability to ensure simplicity and transparency. The industry needs to supplement SEBI's efforts in this regard. Adoption of digital technology right from onboarding of clients to processing of redemption request should be faster so as to further ease the transaction process. My next item which I want to touch is to promote direct plans. While direct plans are available in our market since 2012, the advertisement and publicity for such plans is still being undertaken as a very low-key affair. More investments through direct plans has many advantages such as lower transaction costs, more transparency, and lower instances of mis-selling. There is a strong case for AMFI and the fund houses to educate investors about direct plans and to suitably advertise and promote them. On a related point, I may add that ETFs are another set of products that have yet to catch the fancy of Indian investors. ETFs account for only 4% of total mutual fund AUM in India. Comparative data for US is in the range of around 15%. ETF as a product offers the advantage of having a lower TER as compared to other fund offerings. The investors would be well advised to check the performance of a fund vis-a-vis benchmark index while choosing to invest between an active fund and a passive fund. My last item, which I think is important, is investor education and awareness. 50% of 2 BIPs, that is 1 BIPs, which has been allowed for investor education awareness initiative at AMFI level, that needs to be used for even more meaningful manner. These advertisements which are shown were very good and in fact very well made, but in terms of the B30 approach, or if you want to go to the smaller towns and cities, there is more than this advertisement campaign which needs to be done, and I'm sure 1 BIPs is a big amount, and AMFI will come out with some concrete plan as to how it intends using that. They have to be combined with targeted approach to see that they go to smaller places also. That's what I mean. While I appreciate the enhanced investor education awareness drive by the industry through various media channels, the short-term risk in mutual fund investment should also be adequately highlighted so as to set the right expectations. So there has been some criticism somewhere to say that perhaps the risk factor has not been highlighted in the campaign. So that also naturally needs to be highlighted, that certainly mutual fund investments is not a substitute for, say, bank saving account or something. That is obvious, but perhaps that also has to be straight away told. To conclude, let me borrow a few lines from a recent mutual fund SIP advertisement which I saw, which goes something like this: Pyar aur bharosa dheere dheere badhta hai. In this context, it needs to be understood and appreciated that more than anything else, maintaining public confidence in the integrity of mutual fund industry is very important. End of the day, good governance, discipline, and right conduct are conducive to healthy development and long-term sustainability of the industry. While I have flagged some issues, I'm sure you all will be equally aware of many more issues. And I feel this summit is a very good forum, which I found last year also, to come and jointly discuss and iron out concerns. And in case some policy recommendations emerge from this summit, please feel free to give it to SEBI, which will be examined on priority, and will be, if anything further requires to be done, we will do it positively. We already have MFAC and we have good repo with MFI, so any suggestions are welcome. And in the end, I just thank again for inviting me and wish all the best to the summit. Thank you.